For the past years, the need for more power plants has been pushed because of the rotating power outages in many parts of the country. The push towards renewable energy has also been highlighted. But now, there is an oversupply of power from a renewable source of energy in the Negros Island region. Lawmakers are not too happy about it.
It is anomalous. It is clearly anomalous. Maliwanag naman yung demand ng Negros eh. Admittedly, interesado yung investors sa race to fit niya. Gusto niyang makuha yung kotang yon. But why did government allow it? That's what I cannot get and what I do not understand. In fact, that borders even on graft.
At a joint Congressional Power Commission hearing, Senator Francis Escudero questioned energy officials why there are too many solar power plants in Negros. The Energy Department reveals Negros Occidental alone has several solar farms with over 320 megawatts installed capacity. The region also has biomass, geothermal plants, and other sources of energy. But Negros only needs less than 300 megawatts. Lawmakers say investors may have been quickly building solar power plants because of the government's feed-in tariff incentives, a statement admitted by the National Renewable Energy Board.
They built anywhere they wanted to, no, without considering the transmission line capacity. No, so it did not yield good results, no, because now, as earlier mentioned, you have stranded solar plants in Negros.
NREB Chairman Jose Layog Jr. says most of the solar plants in Negros are not fully utilized because the excess power can't be shared to nearby Cebu or Panay because of a lack of transmission facilities. He adds, reforms are now being done to prevent the sudden influx of power plants in a single area. Senate Energy Committee Chair Senator Sherwin Gatchalian hopes the Energy Department can map out where renewable energy projects should be developed across the country.
Ang importante na klaro sa Department of Energy kung saan mga lugar na pwede magpatayo ng solar, ng wind, para makikita natin kung na pantay-pantay yung pagpapatayo ng solar and wind.
Despite some issues, energy officials are still pushing for more investments in the renewable energy sector. Layog asserts the Philippines is now the leader in renewable energy in Southeast Asia, and with the cost of RE technology expected to go down further, power rates in the country may also go down with it. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.